Hello YouTubers. So I've made some tweaks to the schematic from the previous video. I've added some screw terminals for the LED output, and I've also changed some of the pin assignments so they don't conflict with SPI and I2C. So I think this schematic is good to go. So we'll convert this to a PCB and start the layout process. So here's all our components. Now our PCB size is going to be constrained pretty much by the screw terminals and the header pins. So what I'll do to begin with is just lay out the components in the general area that they'll end up in the finally routed PCB. So that's our components pretty much laid out in their final positions. I'm going to do a ground pour of copper on the bottom and top of the boards. So for now, I'll just switch off the ground net so it makes it easier to see what we're doing. And I think we're now ready to lay out the output stage. So let's start some wiring up. And now we can move on to the power regulator, which supplies the 3.3 volt supply to the ESP32. And finally, we can wire up the gpio pins to our headers and also wire up the indicator LEDs for TX, RX and the power supplies. And we need to route our 5 volt supply out to one of our header pins and also to the top end of the FETs for driving the LEDs. So that's all the routing done. We need to set a board outline now and also do our pours of copper for the ground planes. So we'll do that next. So that's our PCB all laid out. All our DRC checks pass and all our nets are connected. So we can now go and generate the Gerber file and submit it to JLPCB for manufacture. So we can pick some options for how many boards we want, what type of thickness we need, and we can see we get an approximate quote. So for these boards, it will be $4 to manufacture them. So let's submit this order to JLPCB and get a complete quote for SMT assembly. So here we are in JLPCB. So we're just uploading our Gerber file and you can see a preview of it. So let's pick the options. We'll have a 2-layer board. It's worked out the dimensions. We'll just order 5 PCBs. We'll stick with 1.6 for the thickness. Use green. Use all the defaults for copper weight, gold fingers, and material type. We don't need panelization. We don't need castellated holes. And we only have one design. We'll let them keep their order number. If you choose not to have it, then you get charged extra, so we won't do that. What we will do is turn on SMT assembly. So we need to assemble the top side. We can order 2 or 5 SMT assembled boards, and we'll allow JLPCB to decide where to put the tooling holes We could define this ourselves, but it's easier just to let them do it. So now we need to add our BOM file, the bill of materials. So we return to EasyEDA and we go and export our BOM. So export the BOM to an Excel file. And then we need to add the CPL file. So we go back to EasyEDA, switch to the PCB view, and we save our pick and place file. So export that as well. Now back on JLPCB, we can add those two files to our order. So you can see here, it's analyzed our BOM file and it's matched the components up to their parts list, and they've confirmed that they're the correct ones, and they've given us an approximate price for the components. And then down the bottom here, we have the parts that they won't be doing for us. So the ESP room module, the header pins, and the screw terminals. These components we'll have to source and solder ourselves. So we hit next. We have a preview of where our parts will be placed. And then we can hit save to cart and order this PCB. So you can see our total price is going to be £14. So in a couple of weeks, or hopefully in less time, maybe in a week, we should get a partially assembled PCB with the SMT components mounted. And all we need to do is manually solder our through-hole components and the ESP32 through module. So I hope you enjoyed this video. I've certainly enjoyed making it, and if you did enjoy it, please hit the subscribe button because there'll be more videos coming. Thanks for watching, and see you in the next video.